There we go. Now we have different source art. She turned out pretty good. A lot better than I thought she would. Alright. Straight into the Archivist. So she looks very dark. I'm gonna go over to the airbrush booth and actually paint her with a... Well, I'm not sure actually. Because she's not very photogenic or anything on the stream when she's all dark like that. But I think I'm at... you can see, really see the reflection, which is a good thing. So I think I'm gonna leave her that way, but I'm gonna hit her with a little bit of gray here in just a second. All I did to change that was I added a gray, so she's a little better. The color in the photo is actually like a really pale dark green. Oh, thank you for the tip on that. Yeah, I might have to move the camera. I'll ask for your help with that later to kind of test, but she's kind of a gray green. So I want to try to figure out where to start with that. I like this Caspian blue. It's actually darker than that in real life. It just looks really blue on camera. Nope. So I'm going to try to do just a bunch of thin coats like I did before, and I think I will do this Caspian blue. I do have ball bearings in these, but after a while you gotta really shake these up. Alright, fan off or it'll dry my palette out too much. There we go. Thinning this. And I'm probably going to use the same brush here. This is that heavy metal standard brush again, but it has this really nice tip to it. Now I'm not doing this as a base coat. My base coat's already done. I'm doing this as a highlight. To kind of get the lighting figured out. Starting there. I need to thin it even further. Way further. Wow. Okay. Yeah, there's so much pigment in these paints. You can see how much I took from thinning out that little bit I took. Like I said, I don't want this to be overpowering. I just want it to be a basic amount here. It's part of the problem, though, is when you thin it that much, it's almost a wash, and I don't want that. I don't want it to pool, so it's tricky. I just take a lot of... Yeah, I know. No, it helps that I drink a lot of canned beverages at my desk, because then I'm not as likely to do that. And, hi, Paris. I have no idea what you just said. I can probably translate it. Let me try this. Oh, hi. Well, that was easy. Hi yourself. All right, so I've already got kind of an idea where I want the light to go, and you can really see that. I want it to go across here and down, and then right here. It helps that I have the... See, I'm just layering this up a little bit at a time. It helps that I already have the lighting, so you can kind of see where I'm going, almost. Another translation. Thought I left the tab open. Oh, that's okay. You can just follow along and just kind of see what I do. You don't have to follow along completely. With starting such a dark base on this cloth, it's tricky because I'm not sure exactly what to take it. I'm kind of feeling my way around. I have an idea of what I want to do, but it's not incredibly obvious, to me at least. I'm just kind of following the contours here, brightening it up in the spots that I want it to be brightened. I'm thinking it'll end up being a lot brighter than it is, but this is a good starting color to get me there. It may even be a nice green, almost like, I don't know what to call it exactly. I want to say like a medieval green, but you know that like, almost like dark green that you'd see. It's not like a military green, it's not like a forest green. I don't know how to describe it. see if it purchasing some tickets. Yep, that drawing will be at the very end of the month on the... Let's see, it will be... On the 30th is my last stream for this drawing. It will be the last Candy Death stream on the 30th. Actually, you can hardly see it, but her... Sorry, I'm trying to get her hood here, too. Her shoulders, especially in the art, it's hard to see on the miniature, but her shoulders are uncovered, and then she has different colored sleeves. And I do really kind of want to try to get that pale white going. It's tricky, because it's not a normal thing, but I like it. With this layer, I'm just trying to get a feel for where I want all the contours to be. It's not necessarily going to turn out this way, but this gives me an idea. And then I'm used to painting the pattern as I go along, so when I start doing it for real, I'm used to it. I don't have to change too much. Looks. The way this is turning out, I'm not sure exactly where I'm going to go with it. Because I have this bearing blue too, that's a really nice bright blue. I'll see how that looks on the palette and then kind of go from there. Separate already. Alright, I'm kind of mixing the two together a little bit. We'll see what that does in terms of color. Yep, just makes it a little bit brighter, which is what I wanted. Not much brighter, but brighter. Looks really weird on the palette, but hopefully you'll see it a little better in the effects on the mini. Normally this would be a miniature I'd airbrush, but I really want to try figuring out the detail on my own. Okay, I'm going to switch now to a darker blue. Cantabric blue? Yeah, that's cantabric blue. and I'm kind of block in all of the dark areas that I avoided earlier. And I'll kind of use these three colors with a lot of blending to get a nice contrast going. As you can see already, it's a nice... I'm not painting over all the black to create an artificial shadow. I'll see how this dries and then I might come back. A lot of it you do have to wait for it to dry, so. Glad I finished the weaponsmith so soon, because now I can kind of devote a little more attention to this as I figure out the blending. Like I said, I'm just not trying to be too particular about it. I'm just trying to follow the places that I wanted to avoid earlier and build in some definition. Cloth can be a lot of fun if you're patient with it. If you expect to get results in two layers or something, rethink that. Nice thing about cloth is since the contours are so smooth, there are a lot of ways for you to just keep adding layers without really losing any detail, as long as they're nice thin layers. The more you add, the more definition you add. So just kind of go with it. Take your time. Nope, not thin enough. I'm putting on a layer. It was really thick. You can see I'm hitting spots that I wouldn't necessarily want to hit, but I'm not too worried about it because this is the darker color. I'm going to easily blend that back up again if I wanted to. There, by the time I'm back, this is already dry, and it's already... it's already blending pretty good. Now I can go back to that lighter tone. Go back over here. Start doing that again. Build that up. Certain spots. Come back with that original green. Hit some broader areas. Alright, need to get more paint on the palette, I'm running out. That Caspian blue again. Very first coat we used. I've got a better idea of what I'm going for. I'm locking in some of these areas a little better, getting a nice coat going. Because before I was just doing very thin layers. Now I kind of have an idea of what I'm going for. So I'm brightening up the spots that I want to brighten up. A lot of these same techniques were in the Storm Knight video. But this one's a little different because I'm trying to achieve a certain specific effect. That one was just kind of flowing where I wanted. But after a while, you got an idea what you were going for. This one, I'm picking out the details as I go rather than kind of getting an idea. Like, I had an idea where I wanted the light to be, and then I picked out the shadows, added a highlight, now I'm blocking in the colors again. Before, I was just doing a few spots, picking out like the higher detail. It was a different miniature, so definitely worth watching. That one's up on YouTube. I'm sorry if I'm missing anything on the chat. I don't think I did, but the bot keeps kicking in. Ooh. I better actually take a break here for a second and clear out my airbrush. Forgot to do that. So I'm going to let this dry while I do that. But I want to make sure to get a coat on here. Okay, I'm back. Alright, that should be pretty good and dry. Now I'm going to build up to that brighter layer again, and then do that shadow again, and then just rinse repeat. Because every layer you put in, it's a little bit more defined. Now this brighter layer is going to be a lot brighter. But it also just builds up the color from beneath it, because it is pretty thin, so it won't override the color I just did. And that dark blue is actually still drying over there. Now, it does seem a bit contrasty, because it's supposed to. This is to brighten it up, and I will do another layer on top of this. Another thin layer of the main color, where this layer will show through, and I can do that a few times, actually. And I want to make sure to hit this up here. The reason I do this is because if you don't, then it just looks very flat. You need to show a lot of this detail in unique ways. Otherwise it just looks very, very plain. What's the point in all the detail on this really nice model if you don't show it? Now, her knee you can make even brighter, but it's such a focal point, I want to make sure that, right now, anyway, stuff I do around it doesn't overpower it, because that's a point that really draws the eye, and I want to use that. So, the things, when you look at a miniature, the things that draw your eye, especially on this one, are the knee, the edge here, the top of her hood, her breasts there, and then on the back, it's this curve back here, over there, there, and there, and that's it. Yeah, kind of. Yeah, it kind of does look like Jace. Alright, so now, that whole thing, I want to make sure this is nice and thin. So this is this main layer, but if I don't make it thin, then all that brightening up I just did will be for nothing. Actually, I might wait on that and do the shadow again. Same dark blue, it's gonna dry nice and it's gonna dry a lot darker than it is now and blend a lot better. But I'm using it to get all of that detail in. After a while, you get a feel for what paints will look like after they're dry, especially if you started using a lot of them. That way you know that, like on a blue like this, I'm not stuck with this really bright blue. Hey, that's okay. No worries. Glad those 3D prints are coming along. The bases I was talking about, she's on one of them. It's actually a cast base. Thank you. Oh no, I didn't see it. I didn't see it if you made a post. Sorry, I was prepping for this to get this started. Because I wanted to get an earlier start than I usually do, so that I'm not up crazy late. Yeah, you've got plenty of lanterns. Oh, yeah, yeah. You must have redeemed him. Yeah, I looked through... Yep. I looked through all the tickets people have, and yeah, you had a bunch. It's starting to get there. That's okay, it's definitely worth a try. I'll be streaming all day Saturday. I won't be streaming Kingdom Death stuff, but I'll be streaming some Warhammer stuff. So if you want to come and hang out and earn some lanterns, you totally can. It's good though that you you try. Yeah, don't think you'll fail, because as long as you learn something every time you paint, then you're succeeding. I wouldn't worry about it too much. Now I'm just using that really brighter, the Bering Blue, to really pick out the brightest colors. Sorry the palette isn't as clean as usual. I'm not using that really nice palette paper, I'm just using some baking paper. Hope you can kind of follow along in terms of what I'm doing there. Yes, yes, lots of lights and wires. I could probably even show you, actually. Here, I'll be right back. I wired this earlier in the week, but this is just one of the engines. There we go. Got some flickering red LEDs in there. Still gotta drill out the holes on the sides, but pretty good. Just one of the engines. So that's what I'm gonna be working on Saturday, and it's gonna be a very long stream, so hopefully I'll get the whole thing done, built, wired, painted, everything. I'm even gonna be putting motors into it. Thank you. I had a good helper. Yeah, that's what I got to take to Adepticon. That's why I have that Adepticon trip thing in the top. That $500 goal is to pay for all the painting classes from a lot of cool people. I even got my schedule for that finally from them, which is nice because it tells me where each hall is that I'm going to and what time everything is. Right now I'm trying to get all the folds in her cloth here. Cloaks are looking pretty good. Thinking I just need a little more detail on it. I might get lucky today too. If I end up painting this one really quick, I may end up painting another one. I just don't know which one yet. Maybe a Twilight Witch, or I may do a white speaker. I haven't decided. Thank you. The pinup order knight, no. That's the same thing as I want to make sure that the, I have enough, I'd rather go through all the ones that are more easily replaced. Even the, even this one I have more of, so that I don't want to waste any, if that makes any sense. Where the order knight I didn't get enough of, unfortunately. I will eventually, but probably not soon. Not unless I know they're doing a plastic one. And then it's a no-brainer. I like the color, I'm just thinking it might need something else. Oh, it is it? Really? Champion Weaponsmith is... Oh, it is! Pinup Order Knight. Yeah. That's a good one to do. It's got a lot of cloth on it though, so I'll probably wait until, I don't want to paint the same thing over and over, so I'll probably wait. I will do that one though. Yeah, you're right, it is a white box one. I was thinking of a different mini. My bad. Yeah, the Pinup Order Knight, that sounds pretty good. No, there's just something missing. Like, it looks okay. It's just there's really something missing here. I had to think about this for a minute. Try something here. This blue contrast is a little too much, so I got a really thin layer of that first color. To blend it in. My pad dried out, and so I've got this grit that I gotta work through real quick. It's really annoying. I may actually have to switch back to the original palette paper if that keeps happening. Nope, dang it, too thin, because now it's filling in everything. Like, there's something still off about it. Like, it looks alright, but... Not sure what it is yet. That's okay, I'll keep working. It's the same thing on the scarf of the Great Game Hunter. I may go grab that just to give myself an idea of what I'm trying for. No, it's not just you. I didn't add an audio track this time. I was trying to add some music. But I didn't... it took me forever to try to figure it out, and I just skipped it. So, if you want to listen to what I'm listening to, let me see if I've got a... it's way up here. Here's what I'm listening to right now. I just couldn't figure out how to put it in the stream. Unfortunately. After this layer, I'm gonna let it dry and then I wanna try something. I have some Andrea Miniatures inks. And I don't know, it's just not blending quite the way I want it to. So I'm gonna try something new. It's a lot of time to spend on this cloth and not have it do what I want it to, so. It's actually looking a little better. The blending is a little softer. Oops. Almost mixed with some of the flesh tone I had earlier. Thanks. Very small amount, and I'm gonna thin it with water. Hoping that'll even up the tone a bit. Alright, see, it's very green. I'm just gonna do it on a small area so that I don't mess anything up. I actually like that. What do you know? I'm going to brighten up certain areas and then I'm going to do that ink. So. I'm going to build it up back up to that bearing blue. brightening it up quite a bit so that when that ink hits, it won't dull out too much. After all that, it's starting to blend out better than I thought it would, so I may not need the ink. We'll see. Sorry if I'm a little quiet, it's just the same thing over and over. You just layer on layer. These last three layers were a mixture of first that Caspian blue again, and then a 50-50 Bering blue, and then I slowly added more. Yeah, I'm still streaming. Here, try refreshing the page. If it stopped, it'll come back up. I haven't gone anywhere, I promise. That green now to try to bring it all back up again to where I want, and then I may have to even do a highlight on top of that, but the green should really bring out the color the way I wanted it to. So I'm going to slowly apply it nice and thin. See how that dries. It's actually a lot greener on in person than it is on the stream. Well, it doesn't seem to be blending the way I quite wanted it to. Like it's... Oh, you can't hear... What? That's weird. Definitely is recording on my side. Here, let me unmute. Yeah. It's playing just fine on mine. I might just be really... you may need to turn the volume up on whatever you're watching on. I know I'm a little quiet. Yeah, and that green turned out way too... That green did not do what I wanted it to do, darn it. Should have known better. Should have just known better. Yeah, it looks a lot more blended here than it does in real life. Dang it, I gotta go back and do a bunch of stuff. One mistake. It's okay, live and learn, I guess. Literally have to go back, start with that dark blue. Build up again. Darn it. Idea was good. Better. I'm adding some of that blue again to try to even it out. Actually not that bad. Helps with some of these. Give me a little definition back in some of these curves. There, kind of. There's so many layers, I know, I'm pretty sure it's hard to follow, but I just, at this point you just feel the way you want it to be, and if it doesn't look quite right, you try another layer, don't layer too thick, and then mistakes, like the one I just did. Well, let me see. But do not use it. I tried it and it didn't work out. Don't use it. The three greens I'm using are three bluish greens are Cantabric blue, Caspian blue, and Bering blue. Those are the three I'm using, and I'm kind of blending them as I feel. To try to get a good layering. That's awesome. Thank you, guys. It is starting to be a lot brighter than it was. That's not necessarily a bad thing, though. I've been tempted to use washes, and that's why I wanted to try that ink. But every time I've used a wash, it just hasn't been the way I wanted it to be. Like, it's not quite right. So that's why I'm starting to stray away from washes. Washes are awesome. They make a lot of different things. Hey! I love that panda emoticon. That's awesome. I'm glad you guys are doing so great with your King of Death streaming. You guys are awesome. I wish I could tune into as often as I'd like, but unfortunately, I'm always busy. Which is nice that you post all your stuff on YouTube after. So then I can watch it on my time. Oh, that's awesome. Thank you. While you're here, I was trying to figure this out for like a half hour. I know I can put, there are certain like Twitch music stations that I can put into the stream, but I've had a heck of a time trying to actually put it into OBS. If you have any advice, Twist, I'd really appreciate it. That's why it's a little quiet in stream today. I tried that out instead of my normal track, and then it just did not work out. So there's no music. Studio. Classic, wasn't working for a lot of the things I wanted to do. Go in and try to figure. I tried to find that setting, but couldn't save my life. But now that I know what I'm looking for, it shouldn't be too hard. I don't want to add it now because, well, actually, it's not so bad. I might try to add it now after this layer while I'm waiting for it to dry. Well, I won't be able to to follow along, so I tried So this here, before I get too far. So this last layer was literally just straight bearing blue, thinned down a little bit. It's a little spectral, but it's starting to turn out slowly. I don't know what to do or book in. Looks like it's a dark brown, but I'm not sure how I want to do it. So we'll see here in a little bit. Right now I'm gonna hold this up so you guys can at least look at it, but I'm gonna try to add window capture, yeah. Yep, no luck whatsoever. That's really dumb. Yeah, I'm trying to add music on here, but I don't even see the option. We've got input capture, output capture. Nope, no luck. Oh well. Hey, Katie Baron. Alright, I'm just gonna go right back to this color, trying to block out some more stuff. Oh, it should have desktop audio on the bottom already. Okay. No, I go to settings and it says desktop audio is disabled. And I can't change it, like it won't let me. Maybe it's working, I'm not sure. Nope. I just added a second microphone for my headphones. That's all I did. So it must sound weird. There we go. I just changed it back, unfortunately. Oh well. No, well, at least that's good, but still. Yeah, I don't know. I'll do some searching on it before next stream, but it's no luck. Which is a pity, because I should have just added the regular track. I might just do that now really quick. I don't know if I downloaded it or not. At least the basic one that I usually use. There, give me just a second. I'm gonna add a little music. It's not great, it's what I normally use. I'd rather have some more interesting music, but I'm not cool enough for that apparently. Yeah, I've got internal speakers on my computer. Here, I'm gonna go back to OBS again. Let's make it dumb. What the heck? Well, that's not gonna happen. What the heck? There we go. Well, I'm gonna assume that is the something I need to learn, because OBS literally just closed the window and I can't reopen it. It's still working, but it's like, nope, you can't. I don't want, no. So there's that. That was fun. Now I'm just going back now and trying to pick out some lines that I want to make brighter. Sure how bright I want to make everything, but there are a lot of spots that just need a little bit extra. Once I start adding contrast with all these extra parts, yeah, I know, I just have to sing for you. I'm not sure if my singing voice is that good. I want to, like, start playing the, if I can download it anyway, like the soundtrack to Fallout 4. Yeah, I know you vote. No, you vote for singing. But me just singing to the air without any music, it feels weird. If I start playing the soundtrack to Fallout 4, I'll be singing a lot. So this is ending up being really, really bright, which is good. I mean, I like the contrast, but there's just something missing in it. That's the nice thing about cloth, is you don't really lose any of this detail. You've seen how many times in like the last hour that I've tried to paint this, and I've not really lost any of the detail, which is awesome. But yet at the same time, it's like, why? Why do I have to suffer? Okay. Ah, I see. So this is still her robe here. I'm really trying to pick out all this now. I'm gonna change this up a little bit and start on her arms. I may come back to the cloak, but for now I'm gonna just work on her arms. But it's the same base. I'm probably gonna build this up a lot more than I did the fighter, or the weaponsmith, darn it, it's a weaponsmith. But for now I'm just gonna start with this Cadric flesh again. And at some point along this, I'm definitely gonna have to switch to a new palette. Because this one's really drying out. It's like not even using a palette pad anymore. So I'm just thinning this Cadric flesh. I'm just gonna paint her hands, or her fingers rather. Her hands are covered completely. And then she's got some bare skin. Oh no, I'm not even going high enough, or am I? This is where her bare skin is. I know it's a little too pink, but I wanted to at least start with that. And you know what I might do? It's supposed to be a full sleeve, but I think I'm just gonna use it all the way here. Yeah, it must have been in the mold that I lost a little bit of that detail of where the sleeve line is. So I'm just gonna leave this as bare skin here. And of course I gotta go in and under her hood and get that going. Yeah. I want it, but I don't want it that thick. And she's got glasses, so I'm going to try to avoid that. Looks almost creepy. Yeah, I don't know why OBS's window just died. So, I'm sorry about the positioning if it's not quite right. It's because I'm not watching it. Especially I'm not watching the feed live. On the computer, at least. So, I'm trying to get in here and hit all of her skin so I don't miss anything. Although, you know what? Her skin and her face are pale enough. I'm going to try something new. I'm gonna go straight for this Rin flesh, and then I'll build it up to like a pale white from there, instead of doing it the other way around. Normally I start pretty dark, but this time I wanna start really light. That's really bright. That's what I want. Yeah, she is so pale. It's okay, she's a book nerd. Quite obviously. Let's not go outside much. I think this is a miniature from... and this is another reason this one wasn't reproduced. I think this is going to be one of those from the Twilight Knight standalone game. Oh, that's why I went over a bit on here. There, that actually looks successfully creepy. I like that there are no eyes. It's just this hollow mask. I like that, actually. Like, maybe she's not even human anymore. She's just some creature that only comes out to record things. Interesting. Yeah, I like that a lot. Now she's got this pale cloth. Let's see if I can find something that'll work for that. I'll have to do it really thin, but I've got this Arctic blue that I think will work. I'm gonna shake that up really quick. Yeah, definitely gonna have to figure something out for this palette, because it's just... it's a bit much. So now that this is so thin, I'm gonna try something. I'm gonna practice on my hand, of course. I'm just gonna so lightly hit this, just to pick out all that detail. But it's like not even layering it on, but it really brings out that extra little bit. It's a really, really thin Arctic blue too much. See? You gotta like ghost tint it. There we go. Yeah, because then it's not too much. Yeah, I like that. It's perfect. It's just what this needed. I knew there was something missing. It's like a really, really pale blue-gray. Well, here's the mark of my next stage of painting evolution. I'm starting to paint on my hand. All those crazy painters in Russia and Poland. I see that all the time. Like, people take work in progress photos of their painting, and like, there's so many little things of paint on their wrists and on the backs of their hands and thumbs. Like, now I know what that's from. So I'm trying to get most of the paint off while leaving it a little bit. That's interesting. That's awesome. I still building it up to that brighter color, but it's going slow. Purposefully slow, but slow. She kind of does look like Jace from Magic the Gathering at this point. That's a nice pale, sorry, I don't know if you can see it. It's really nice pale white for her sleeves here. Thanks, Skuna, for trying to tune in. I know it's hard during the middle of the day. I will definitely be posting this one on YouTube. I've learned a lot painting this one so far. Mostly about thinning and like very, very thin layers and kind of seeing how transparent paints can be and then just kind of building up each layer. Like, her sleeves look great. Sorry if you can't see them. I'm trying to keep them in focus, but like I said, my browser window just... My OBS window just died on me. So yeah, she's turning out great. The sleeves are really showing up. I'm trying to layer here on slowly and bring out all the cloth. And I don't know, it's turning out great. It's just time consuming, I guess. I'm actually gonna get a black this time and try to get her glasses. I'm gonna leave her eyes straight black because I think that just looks creepy and awesome. nice. Well, I hope you're learning a decent amount, Skuna. It's kind of my learning stream, too. I've learned a lot here and there, but I don't have a lot of time to put new things into practice, so that's kind of where I'm going with this. With the stream in general, anyway. Yep, that's true. Some of the best miniatures I've ever seen have taken 1,000 hours to paint. Like, not even kidding, 1,000 hours. Whoa, I don't know what I did there. Sorry. I really messed up her eye. I don't know if you can see that. It's really bad. It's really easy to get impatient when you're painting, and all right, give me just a second. Somebody's at the front door. Be right back. You can hear my music in the... There it goes. Just went back onto my headphones. Alright. So, I'm trying to think of how I want to do the... I do want to put another layer on her shoulders. Oh, nice. You are building spidey-kills. Nice. Nice, cool. Pirate monkey painting, I'll write that down. Because I'm learning too, so it's good to have that. Of course I don't have a pen. I'll just have to remember. Alright, so I'm gonna go from there. Her book is really dark brown. Let's see if I can get a dark brown here. There we go. Oh, I already had one on. I just couldn't see it. Oh, nice. Oh, nice. It's a block. Cool. I'll open that up and save it for later. So Actually, come to think of it, I might have seen this guy. No, I haven't seen this guy before, but it's definitely worth a try. Cool. Nice. Cool. Oh, thanks. Yeah, no worries either way. Knowledge is knowledge. And I think we all need it in painting all our kin to death stuff, so no worries. I know a lot of other Twitch streamers are like, try to make it all about them and try to self-promote a whole lot, but I mean, I appreciate doing that, but like, knowledge is knowledge. I'd rather, you know, everybody get something rather than me boycott all that. If I were the best of the best, then I could say, yes, learn everything from me, but I'm not. I'm definitely not the best of the best. Yes, the chair is awesome. It is not the normal, like, gaming chair. Although I'm not taking full advantage of it, because I'm not leaning back, but... It is a really nice trail. My girlfriend helped me pick it up. Actually, she pretty much suggested it. Nah, I just bought it, so she did all the work. She put it together. So I can't take any credit for that. I just bought the thing. Oh, yeah, it's not a racer, though. Like, that's the company, but, like, it's not one of their... It's a different kind of chair. Like, not the normal gaming chair for them. But yeah, that's definitely the company. Okay. Trying to think. I think I'm just gonna do a metal spine on there. It looks like I've got some pages I gotta figure out. It's also got this thing, it's... sure what it is. It's hard to spot. Oh, it's part of her cloak. What do you know? There's this... I don't know if you can see it, but it's right here. So I'm gonna take some of that blue and go back in here and get that. It doesn't have to be perfect, because it's really not very visible. But I do want to hit it, just because... You were in lanterns too. Definitely need those. If you get 250, enter the enter. Make sure to go to the link that keeps coming up, and enter the drawing. All right, I'm gonna do another quick layer on her sleeves here. I'm gonna make this one really light, because I still want to have it see through, but I want it to give a little more clarity here. Yeah, the way it's going, I'm definitely going to have to... It's only 4. I'll get this done by 5. Yeah. Yep. I'm way early on this one, because this one was all cloth. I'll have to go back in and work it. Head to the basement, find another miniature to put together. So that'll be a triple stream, not a double stream. Got a little of that skin tone on her cloth here, but I'm not too worried about it, because I'm just covering it up, making it even look brighter. Alright, she's got some hair color here too, and I just haven't decided what I want that to be. I'm actually gonna probably do her hair, these hair tassels, as maybe a white, if that fits. And then I'll do her other bag, and I've gotta do the pages of the book. I'm gonna go back and do the base, but for now. Oh, good. Yeah. If you start with Rakarth flesh as a base, that helps a lot. It's a nice solid base that's a good off white, and then most of the time you can get away with just washing that. It really depends on how you want to do it. I'll still look you up the prices on those shoulder pads too. Flesh tone, just to brighten it up, because I need to give her a little more definition in her face. Not a lot, but some. I'm gonna keep going. Time to refresh the palette. So I will be right back. I just have to go get the. I'm gonna toss this. I can't use it anymore. Can't even see it on my palette bed anymore. Might actually have to quit out of my broadcaster software and then come right back. Because I need to see this window. So. I'm still here. I will be back. The stream will stop, but it'll come right back. If you stick around, the. Revlobot that's giving you lanterns, that will not be shut off. Give me just a second, I don't want to cut the stream off until you guys can hear what I'm saying. Make sure I'm back before I get started. Yeah, I don't know why I wasn't showing the window, that was just weird. Good thing. I'm still here, I promise. Thank you. All right, I'll go grab the wet palette paper. Sorry, I can't see the stream on my side either, so I'm like, what's going on? Dang it, it says. See me now? There we go, okay. Yeah, I don't know why it just takes a while for it to say, yes, I'm working. Okay. So the palette pad isn't too complicated. You can see it's still kind of a little wet. So you basically have this sponge. This is I will make a video on this eventually, I promise. So this is a Masterson's Stay Wet Palette. Basically, it comes with I can't really see it, but it comes with a sponge and then some palette paper, which is this nice white paper. You basically get the sponge really wet. You put the paper in there and then still pour some water in, because it does take a little while for the water to soak into the paper. So I literally just pour a lot of water in, then dump the most of it out until it like stops dripping. Here, I can kind of show you too. Like, none of you can see it, but water is still coming out a little bit. You want to do it until it almost stops. Like, a lot of excess water, you want that to be gone. And then, since the palette, you can still see it, especially in the lower camera. It's still wet. You want that to be completely dry, otherwise it does this. And I don't mind showing you, just a little section. Otherwise it does this. So we're gonna find a wet spot. Doesn't matter. And it's still, it'll start to, you'll notice, it'll start to bleed out. You'll slowly see that spot get bigger and bigger. And you don't want that to happen, because then it'll just mix all your colors for you. So you just give it a few minutes to dry up. I'm using some colors, like I'm gonna use a silver that I don't care, it won't spread too much. So I'm not too worried about it. But yeah, I don't know why it's sad. Just that one delay of Twitch not saying I'm online went from 20 viewers to 6. So, which I don't blame anybody, you know, if the stream's not obviously on, then I don't blame anybody for leaving. It's just Twitch! Traitor! Oh well. So I'm going to try to find a relatively dry spot here so I can start on this brown again. There we go. So eventually I will do some special YouTube videos on tips and tricks for my frequently asked questions, like what type of brushes I use, why I use them, kind of my setup, the wet palette, basic blending, stuff like that, just to get people going, because I get those questions a lot, and I don't mind them, but I don't want to have to answer them every time, so it's easier just to have a command inside Twitch to give somebody a link. These are all things I'm going to do eventually, but it's just hard finding the time, because I still have a regular job, and if this works out, and I can devote more time to it, then I will absolutely do stuff like that. A little bit at a time. Yeah, this is just that same brown as before. This is just like her bag with quills in it. Looks like a grinding stone there. I think that's what that is. No, it's a scroll. Thought it was like the grinder to a mortar and pestle for making ink, but nope. It is just a scroll, unfortunately. Now, this is a very bright brown for this. I don't want to keep it that way. It's just a really nice contrasting color to the rest of the cloth and everything. Nice, got yourself another ticket, Skuna. Good. Stuff. That's an ink bottle. There we go. That's very definitely an ink bottle. I don't know why. I mean, I know she's supposed to have eyes and everything, but I just like those hollow eyes. Fits the whole aesthetic here. Okay. Now I can use this over. If I can find it, there it is. I would normally go for a rope, but I'm liking the idea of silver chain on this. It's a really nice bright thing to contrast the darkness of the cloth. And I like using silver a lot on these. Already messed up something. But it's easy to go back. The reason I used a dark brown on the book is so that I can do this and bring out all the edges. This lighter brown. And there are straps and stuff and locks. I'll do pages, but give that a second. Actually, that's gonna take a little bit to dry, so I'm gonna do that. So it's a brighter one, so I'm gonna do this flayed one flesh. It's pretty thick paint, but it goes on smoothly, so I'm actually gonna take that straight out of the pot. Now make sure you don't go all the way to the edge here. You want to show some depth. So leave some space there. So this is a Kingdom Death Archivist. She's really hard to find anymore. I tried searching on the Kingdom Death store and it's not even in the sold out items. But you just Google search Kingdom Death Archivist and she'll come up. A little change. Most of these figures are a lot of skin, and I wanted to do something a little different. Once this one's done, I'll grab another miniature and start painting that. I'll even include building it on the channel or stream or whatever. Channel is more, it's still a channel, but I don't know, channel is more of a YouTube term, at least to me. Don't forget too, as you're watching, definitely make sure you're getting lanterns for the through Revlo, because I'm going to give away one of these at the end of the month. This last Tuesday, or Thursday, the 30th, I'm doing a giveaway. And you'll earn lanterns just by watching, and then you redeem those for entries into the drawing at the end of the month. So if you're just tuning in, make sure you head over there and get signed up. Thank you. hard to see, but I gotta get the pages down here now. Wow, there's a multi or a bubble from the casting. At least it's on the bottom, didn't have to fill that in. Actually a really nice white too, so I'm actually gonna put a little extra on my palette. Nice and thinned. I'm gonna use this on her face here. So pale. I love that it's almost looks like a mask. It actually has more definition in person, believe it or not. There, awesome. And I'm gonna do a silver spine here too. The book. Here too. All of these little additions to the way it's sculpted adds something extra. She's a lot more subdued than most King of Death figures, but I like it. Missing stuff. Keep missing the parchment here in her scroll. Wash on the base, so I'm gonna paint that next. If I can do a wash all at once. So the way I did the faces on the last one, the Kenny Cassandra Gray. Just wanna do really nice base coat. Thank you. Okay. Looking good. Trying to think if there's anything else. I think I want to do a little work on our hands, but other than that. Wrong color. I'm gonna go back to this really pale Rin flesh from P3. But in the meantime, she should be pretty dry for the next layer, which is just a dry brush after a sip of something. Okay, now going to a lighter gray, which I usually do on all my stone face bases. If I were airbrushing, it'd be a little different. Drop my brush all the way down below my desk. Chair. Cooperate. There we go. I'm back. Alright. Now I'm going to take the space on my palette for this. I got my handy dandy dry brush thing. Just an old plate or something. Just after a while it builds up these nice bumps and ridges. So you're almost dry brushing before you start dry brushing. Which is awesome because then you know how much is on there. But here, it's out of the way. So I'm literally just dry brushing the top of these faces. And what little terrain there is on the bottom. It's not too particular. Like, just dry brushing. Very little paint on there. You can do a little more than that, and there's like this pool area. I'm gonna fill that in with something cool. Maybe blood or something, I haven't decided. Nah, I think I'm gonna do something special. Take it over to the airbrush booth just to finish this up. All right, now that that's done, I can move on and do the wash on the rest of the parts here. Get her finished up. Alright, this is it works on gray really nicely too. This is the same sepia wash as before. So I'm just going to start on the bass so I know that's done. It's a nice, like, old, pale color. I use this for a lot of things. It looks good on ruined buildings. It looks good on pretty much any stone you want to look old and dirty. Dark gray, lighter gray dry brush, and then this. You know what, I'll fill in that spot. I think it looks good just like that. Just like that. I was going to add something interesting to that, but I think it would clash with the somber tones of the figure a little too much. And then the sepia wash also makes the leather look a little more realistic. And then it also darkens up the parchment here in her scroll. Same with all of her silver chain. Darkens that up nicely. Make sure you get all the pages. Don't forget that wash likes to pool a lot, so you don't want to have too much on the pages. Just enough to make it look like a really old book that she's been carrying around and writing a story in for a very long time. And then you also want to wash the entire front. Sorry, out of focus here. You also want to wash the entire front, even though it's very dark. You still want to wash it to kind of blend those colors together nicely. And then also that tarnish on the extra end here. Don't forget to do the back lightly. And there you go. She's done. I left her face very, very pale because I figured that was appropriate. But that's it. She's done. Cool. I'm going to set her aside. So let's do a quick little recap after I take her off the base here. There they are. Yeah, the pinup weaponsmith done. Her axe is really awesome. I might use that for another miniature. And then the scribe, or the archivist. Got them done. And I will post videos for both of those later. Alright, now I gotta work on building the next one. I'm just gonna do a regular base for this one. Nothing too special. I'll glue them on, clean them up, try to fill in any gaps.